It's our Independence Day, September 21st, 1981. We gained our independence from Great Britain. Belize was originally a British colony, and it was first settled in the 16th birds, that's all. And for the 10 days that you're here, I'm sure we're gonna get there, right?
Balls hot outside.
Someone's gonna open the door and be like, why are you trying to get in my room?
Seriously.
Throughout all the generations. So today, we call our kids picnic. So I'm asking how many kids, if any of you have kids?
Yes.
Yes?
Carefully. Climbing is not mandatory, but it is a great part of the tour. You get a great experience. So we're gonna, I tell him a quarter to seven, is that with you? An hour and a half, and then like 15 minutes if they need the restroom. And
yeah,
I'm so happy. Okay. You have the middle class and then the poor people. As you go out into the broadleaf forest here at Altoona, the buildings and the mounds, they get smaller. Some of these buildings, you could see bricks. You could see flintlock. The flintlock, of course, is restoration work, but the bricks, this is how the royal people used to build their buildings, whether it's a church, whether it's a structure for the underworld, for the sun god, they would build from bricks. Those little buildings just behind you, they had a solid foundation and they would put
I'm not flying with you.
tactical gears, your masks. Once we're done from there, we officially start the day by getting everyone back in the boat, introducing my other partner, Darrell. He's gonna be another guy with us today. Then we head over to the snorkeling side and then we have some fun. It should take us no longer than a minute to get to the dive shop. When we get there, I'd like all of you to remove your flip-flops or your tennis shoes.
Month of the 24th, 2023.
That's barely a waiver.
Day month here.
Stepping at your right foot first. There you go. Then your left goes here. You can now lift it up and go for it. Hold on to this.
Yep.
Let it go.
Let it go.
How about there? Fix this. Okay, 10 more butter. How about that? Good?
That's fine.
Tell me about this one. How about that? Just hold on to your gloves.
Thank you.
Just ask them to do it.
Do it upside down.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Right. Right.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my
god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my
god. Oh
dale.
Somebody come get that girl.
Right.
Hi, friend. Hang on, this one the whole time?
Nope. Oh, you come here. You gotta break at the very end. Come here.
Oh, here.
Sit down. Knees up. And there's your eyes.
sit down. Knees up, go forward. Look at them. Keep your right hand sliding, whenever you see some motion, you pull down, right?
Mm-hmm.
Go for it. Go for it. Hand on the lower cable, pull up or jump.
Michael Jackson.
Pull that up together. Sit down. Knees up. Go for it. Keep it sliding, keep it sliding, keep it sliding. Hands on the lower cable. Hands up here. Pull up or jump. Keep your hands sliding. Whenever you see his hand motion, pull down, right? Sit down. Knees up. Go for it. Place both hands in the lower. Tip toes. That's it. This one goes here. Step on this side.
I don't know, dude. I'll probably mess up on the next one. You may as
well come on. Guys, you break too much, you're going to exercise a lot, okay?
Yeah, I don't want to work out.
Also, an underground river that feeds this river is the reason why this river never goes dry. The 2019 was the driest year so far that I know while here. Well, I've been here since 2010. I don't know if any other year was so dry like that. But that year was very, very dry for us in Belize. And this river got very low in some areas, right? So the water is not drinkable, right? So don't drink it. Not now, right? Maybe early in the morning when nothing has been started as yet, you know, no activity with creatures of the forest. And the only water you can drink is the water dripping from the ceiling of the cave, right? It's being filtered by the rock. So the rocks are slippery, so watch your step, right? Have algae on them.
Hi, Kareem.
Hi.
Oh God! I know they said cold, but I didn't think they meant cold.
Oh, I'm like, oh, great.
God!
Most of the fish we have is cichlids. Cichlids, Mexican dentos.
Just keeps getting deeper. You would think it would get
deeper.
I think it's like the tsunami.
Yeah.
Right. You just like are slowly declining.
Do you want to? Are you? Do you want to book your? Yeah, I didn't know. Do you want me to hold something?
I'm like, this feels warmer than home. You guys are like, it's so cold.
Okay.
I know, it feels great.
More water.
I just don't want to take you out on my way down.
Gotta get high. Okay, the tide is heavy. Jesus. Ready. I'm ready to just start rafting.
We're gonna be splitting the groups in two, okay? A group of seven and a group of eight.
Okay. Oh, are they all tied together? So one group will be, okay. I feel safer that way. Rather than just by myself.
It's like, do I want to tighten?
No one swimming?
No.
No one swimming.
I don't care.
Or you could just do right here.
See the
buffer?
Yeah.
I feel like that'll give you an opportunity.
Oh, yeah. Happy to take any of you guys.
I'm trying to turn it on again. I'm so mad. Is it
going to stay up high?
No.
Everyone, to work your lights, it's on your right hand side. You take and you spin forward to get them on. Right hand side. Don't do the left because the battery is going to fall.
Is it on?
Yeah. You're good.
On right, okay?
Can we turn them on now?
No.
Yours on.
I saw it.
We have to get it off, it's backwards.
Okay, so we should. No.
Is mine off?
The one that can't listen.
I'm gonna take it. Lift and let's
Hey, there you go. You got one for free.
With your feet.
Off we go, guys.
Oh, yeah, over there. Woo!
come, guys. The water is deep enough. Sit back, relax, make yourself comfy, and enjoy the float, okay? Deepest point today, we're talking a little bit over 30 feet. Please go to the next.
I think I bring the wrong cube. This is very uncomfortable.
Also, when the cave is narrow, the water is deep. This is the deepest section, approximately 30 or 4 feet deep. Let us turn our lights off.
Everyone, turn your lights off.
Spin it backwards.
Almost.
Branches, roots, and the trunk. That is the meaning of the ceiba tree for Mayan people. So that's why they believe this is the tree of life. And this is why these people still worship the ceiba tree as well. Okay? In by being seen these places, we can see the representation of all of that meat.
An excavated tomb.
Where is mama? Where is your mama? Spider monkeys. So first they found evidence about Mayan cosplays in the cities, like internal cosplays.
Do we now know what they use? You have a great office.
Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias.
How did you say this guy was? The rain god?
Yeah, the rain god. God, what I wouldn't give to just hop this right now. I know.
Do it! Climb in a temple. On a mountain. I don't know. Feeling tall. But I'll tell you. Skinny does not equal in shape.
No.
Is that the next one we're going to?
Maybe. Maybe. I know, he said temple four is closed.
These are royal palaces. And more stairs. Of course there are. It's not really the heat that bothers me.
It's the sun. For me, it's the heat. Because my lungs.
No, I set a timer for the sunblock. Mm. 80 minutes, then time to reapply.
Yeah.
So I got burned the other day at the beach. I'm not doing that again.
I reapplied. My stack is all poured my walkthrough here. This is cool.
Holy moly. Yeah, very Indiana Jones. Where's my diamond skull out, yo? Have you seen the newest one? I haven't seen the newest
one.
I
liked it. I hope it's the last.
Wasn't it Thomas Ford, or what's his name?
Harrison
Ford.
Yeah.
Isn't it his last one?
Yeah. It should be. I think it should be the last one for the franchise, period.
Did they set it up for a new person to take?
There's the tip of the temple up there. My hands are so shaky. Alright, I'm gonna go back where they were.
the cat dog thing.
Yeah, the.
Is that the scientific term?
Yeah, that's what he said. It was kind of like a cat.
It's a cat dog.
I forget what it's called.
So this is where basically all the plan of the cow was done. All of it, like about like temple one, temple two, temple three, temple four, temple five, all the positions actually are from this point over here, yeah? And temple five, it is perfectly aligned with Venus, yeah? Temple one, two, three, those are perfectly aligned with Orion's belt, yeah? So we have a show when we have equinox, solstice, that you can see like the structure right over.
Right.
Hey, you guys take a
look
here.
I know my phone went off like 80 times.
That's funny.
Look at this. Be careful going down.
Try not to think about it.
Burgers. They're big too.
You've been given a prime opportunity right here.
Here on my right is Narciso. He's your farmer. He's gonna explain to you everything you need to know about chocolate, where it starts, how it grows, and he's gonna show you the trees, show you the fruit, and you also do get to taste the fruit. So if you do have any questions along the way, just let him know of your questions, and if you do need him to repeat something again, he can also do that. So he's ready.
Good afternoon, folks. How you all doing?
Good.
Good.
How are you?
Fair enough. Fair enough, you know. So, like he rightly says, I am the farmer. My name is Narciso. And nice to meet you folks.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome to our cacao farm. You're in the farm. It does not look like a farm. It looks like forest.
but that's what you're coming to learn about. This will be the first step of chocolate, where this you will learn and see to have full knowledge of where good chocolate comes from. We have good chocolate here, right? So we'll begin by looking at these trees. Let's come to the side over here. Different varieties. We have the red kinds. This one is a Ratinawi. This was from the red varieties, red kind. But they only stay for about a week. And in its right stage, then about a week they start to deteriorate. They're no good. So we harvest them when they're at their right point, when they're ripe and ready. That's when we harvest them. So the seeds of the fruit here, my friends, are what produced by us farmers. We sell them to the factory where they're made into chocolate. That's what you're out here for, to make chocolate. But we love to bring our guests on the farm first, so we can have full knowledge of good chocolate. So cherries, this will be the only time when no machetes are required. No machetes. Our machetes are sharp. If you use the machete to cut the fruit, you will definitely damage the seeds in there. Not good, non-organic. So we use a piece of stick to open up the fruit. We walk to those piles with a piece of stick, and you just walk them in the middle. Now you rotate a bit and it breaks open. This is the starting of chocolate right here, my friends. It's a fruit. It's not like chocolate yet. This is the starting of chocolate right here.
And after seconds of grinding, you can start to see and smell chocolate. You can come even closer and take a look at what's happening on the stone.
Better now, right? Yeah. Welcome. There we go.
She just watches the people sometimes.
So I don't know why, but the second to last hotel we're in tonight, I got a room to myself. But these rooms are not rooms, they're like condos. And let me just show you. The view from the front door, a whole kitchen. Living room, complimentary whole water. Living room, eating area, nice. Did I just lock it instead of, no. I guess I'm not going out here. Well, I couldn't get the doors open, so whatever. Bedroom. Nice. I was about to say, is there another door? There's not. It's a nice view though. And then, with a tub and it's a jacuzzi tub. Okay, I think there's a second room too. This has a lock on it, so maybe not. Okay, so definitely for large groups of people.
But there, my friend right there, he runs the gym.
Yeah, right here,
right there, right?
but some stay open when it is happening.
Yeah. Some take a little loss.
Got a ride like Dixon Dallas. I didn't say that. So, we survived horseback riding. We did not survive it unscathed because look at how cut up my leg is. And then this leg got some of it too. The horse just wanted to drag me into the bushes. It also wanted to be the slowest horse. But I love horses and I have fun still. And now my thighs hurt. And I asked the guy before we went, do I have to wear pants? Because anytime I've ever ridden a horse before, they were like, wear pants. So I specifically asked the guy, I was like, so do I need to wear pants? And he was like, no, you can wear your shorts, it'll be fine. We roll up in our shorts, and the actual guy that was taking us on the trail ride was like, y'all might be chafed by the time we come back. You should really wear long pants. I was like, I distinctly asked the man if I had to wear long pants. But lesson learned, I knew that. I knew that in my cabeza. I just chose to ignore it. Lesson learned about that.
Better than a cockroach.
Yes.
Those who didn't see the kinkajou, you can see them right here. They're nocturnal, so they're pretty much sleeping, but you can see them right here in their burrows. One is right there. And they're a mammal. They're closely related to monkeys. Section is generally for tapirs. It's a double back, so we come through and then we have to double back out to go to the zoo, right? And here you can find the white tail deer. These are the ones they mostly hunt in the waterway. Yeah, that's a baby croc. He's about 2 months old. Hey guys, how you doing? Hey. Lots of them in here, literally hundreds of them.
Hundreds?
Yes.
Crazy.
It is extremely tasty.
Wow.
Better than the normal pork that we have. I don't know, I never tried one. But they're protected by law, so we're not allowed to hunt nor eat them. Right? Pickery. Creole would say pickery. She's a superstar of the zoo. She was found as a kitten. She was abandoned by parents.
Like this trip.
Yeah. Like this trip, right?
And the guy will be the dominant one in the group, and unless he's challenged, he will continuously lead that group until he dies.
Getting in my laps today.
Yeah, they love playing. That's their main.
I think I want to get all.